The following program is a production of HGW Entertainment, heard on the official website of HGW Entertainment. It's that time once again for HGW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
You gotta be the man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada and would like to call us at 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/ATW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us ATWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god! J-D-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of ATW Entertainment Radio, on the official website of ATW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark. The champ is here!
Loving power to the people right now, huh?
I am. Thank you guys so much for voting for me tonight.
Oh.
This is my first ever Divas Championship, and I'm so excited. I promise to make everybody so proud, and thank you guys. I can't thank you enough. It really does prove power to the people.
Kelly!
What am I supposed to say about that? Well, I know she wants to become a broadcast journalist after she retires from wrestling, so I guess I could say it like this. Dreams do come true. Well, I guess if you believe in them enough, they do. But I remember that night, and it kind of really did frighten me when that happened, because as much as I wanted it to be a dream, it was all too much of a reality. You're listening to HGW Entertainment Variety Radio with me, Jonathan Clark.
Oh, and Kelly has a reversal. Shoulders down.
Let me, I've been stuck imagining. Hey guys, this is Star Venus, and you're listening to ATW Entertainment Radio with Jonathan Clark.
Wow, absolutely wow. It is time once again for another edition of ATW Entertainment Variety Radio. It just seems like we did another one just a few days ago. Back again with another installment. I'm Jonathan Clark. If you're not already, follow me on Twitter at JonathanClark1, ATW Entertainment. We're following a significant amount of celebrities and professional wrestlers, a mixture of everything, at Twitter.com, JonathanClark1, ATW Entertainment. If you've been keeping up with what we've been posting on Twitter, we have a number of different images from our Photo Bucket Image Center. Of course, it's powered by Photo Bucket. We have over 830 images in our Image Center on our official website. We just recently tweeted some photos on our Twitter account of Kelly Kelly's Maxim magazine photo shoot. The cover is up there, and we also have an image that I believe she took herself with a provocative expression on her face. We're going to be getting into all that this week for this week's edition of ATW Entertainment Variety Radio as we talk about Vince McMahon and Kelly Kelly. I think the relationship between Vince McMahon and Kelly Kelly has been growing significantly closer and stronger over the last number of months as Kelly Kelly continues to improve and impress the WWE fans. A different Kelly Kelly, an entirely different Kelly Kelly from what we've seen back in the years of 2006-2007. I think the fans are really enjoying seeing Kelly Kelly all the time. We recently talked about Kelly here in an edition of ATW Entertainment Variety Radio on YouTube, putting together a column where I believe that Kelly Kelly was a bit overrated, being shoved down her throat a little bit too much. Maybe I was a little bit too harsh talking about Kelly Kelly in that last audio commentary and video for YouTube.com, JonathanClark22. There was a fan who sent us in his opinion about Kelly Kelly. We're going to be talking about that during the course of this week's program, as I'm going to be sharing his opinion with the fans, and I'm going to be asking your opinion once again on the whole Kelly Kelly situation. The column that I read, actually, on ProWrestling.com detailed Vince McMahon actually being the one who taught Kelly Kelly how to do the Kelly Kelly expositions, which we saw on ECW back in 2006, where Kelly Kelly got her start. Now, originally, Kelly Kelly came from OVW under the name Barbie Blank, a name that she adopted in high school that her friends put on her, and basically she carried that over into her wrestling gimmick, and ever since OVW, coming from there, heading to ECW, adopting the name Kelly Kelly, and you know, it was funny because the name Kelly Kelly is where the name of her finisher actually came from. Her finishing move is called the K2 now, and it took me a while to figure out why she actually called it the K2. I thought it was a stupid name for a finisher. Then I realized that she got the name of her finisher actually from her in-ring name, be it that her name is the same name twice. The name of her finisher is the K2, and it took me a while to kind of figure that out. It takes me a while to figure out some stuff like that with professional wrestling, because I'm more focused on the columns that are posted throughout different websites and news sources throughout the internet. And, you know, I really don't focus on how wrestlers got the name of their finisher or where they actually came from. So it took me a while to kind of put that together and come up with the reason as to why her finisher was called the K2, and it's because she has the same name twice. But Vince McMahon admits to the fact that Kelly Kelly actually got the idea of being an expositionist in ECW from him, and Kelly Kelly actually admits to it in a written column interview that she did on the internet that was posted on ProWrestling.com. The relationship between Vince McMahon and Kelly Kelly is something that I think everybody needs to make a mental note of, because if it wasn't for Vince McMahon having her as a favorite diva, as he's had Tori Wilson, Stacey Keibler, and other divas in the past be one of his favorites, I think that Kelly Kelly probably would have never amounted to anything in this business. I think she continues to impress everybody, and more importantly, I think she's continuing to impress Vince McMahon, because he's consistently always putting her over in interviews, and Kelly Kelly continues to repay the favor by always putting Vince McMahon over as a huge inspiration for her in the business. She said in a written column, an interview a while back, that she likes to pattern herself after divas like Trish Stratus and Stacey Keibler. and she always enjoys getting ideas from other fans, and Vince McMahon especially, who continues to have Kelly Kelly as a favorite, no matter if Kelly Kelly is the Divas champion or not. I think Kelly Kelly's reached a point in her career now. Of course, she finally dropped the title 3 pay-per-views too late, in my opinion, to Beth Phoenix. If she was going to drop the title to her, she probably should have done it at a pay-per-view like SummerSlam or Night of Champions, happening a bit too late, in my opinion. I think we should have seen the title switch hands probably at Night of Champions. That probably would have been the appropriate pay-per-view and appropriate venue for Beth Phoenix to become the champion, be it that Night of Champions took place in her hometown of Buffalo, New York, creating a bit of heat.